Sorry, the video got cut off in between because I don't know why. Maybe there was some memory issue or I don't know, either some call might have came. Okay, so I'm just continuing because the last video was cut down from recording and I was continuously speaking for next 20 minutes. Okay, it was like very sick for me. So I have to again write this again and I'm going to explain you. Okay, so from where we left, I'm going to start again. Okay, this was Sun, Mercury, Venus, Moon itself, Jupiter, Saturn, Mars, similarly, Mars, Saturn, Jupiter, Moon, Venus, Mercury, and Sun. Okay, this was the table, I guess. Okay, and we made a rough chart where there was, Venus over here, Sun was over here, somewhere was Moon, I guess, was over here with Sun, I guess there was Mercury was here, and what is left? Saturn was, where was Saturn? I don't know, anywhere we are writing Saturn. Over here we are writing Jupiter. Over here we are writing Mars. Okay, I don't remember exactly. I guess over here I wrote Mars. Okay. And Saturn was over here. Ketu is over here. Rahu is over here. So rough chart. Just to understand this. I don't know where I stopped from. But I think I was explaining the nature moodiness of people who are born in different moon phase. Okay, so people are most moody when they are born in Purnima and Amavasya. Okay, they are most sensitive to moon. Whenever a slightest change in moon, they are going to feel disturbed, totally disturbed. I guess I also explained that if you want to know that in which areas the person is going to be moody, okay, then you have to see that on which phase he is born. Okay. If he is born in the second phase, okay, then you have to see the position of Sun in his chart, in which house Sun is sitting. Okay, on in that house, the person is going to be moody with every change in moon. Okay, now with what intensity that change would be, I was also explaining that. So over here, if the person is born in first four phases, okay, and last four phases. First four phases and last four phases, okay. There is a big intensity change. You can drastically see that the person is moody over here, okay. But over here, from 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, and 10th, this one, there is low sensitivity, okay. The person is not that much moody. Especially in the 7th phase and 8th phase, okay. This is where the person is very less moody. He can control the mood. Okay, they are very well in stabilization. They are totally stable. Okay, where was Krishna born? Krishna was born on Ashtami. That is why we celebrate Satam Atham, the 7th and the 8th phase of moon as Janmashtami. Because they are connected. See, from moon. And where was his moon? Krishna had the moon in first house. Okay, Lagna had the moon in Krishna's kundi. Okay. So, moon was affecting him very much. Moon was on his body. And exactly on top when he was born, 12, midnight. Okay, that is why it was in the first house. So, So we also notice that fourth house from the moon is going to show the water element. Where is water element situated in his body? The fourth house lord is going to show that whether the water element is good or bad. Okay, first you have to see whether any planet is there from fourth house from the moon. If there is a planet, then you have to see whether it is a fire planet or a water planet or an air planet or an earth planet. Okay, if it's a fire planet, then the water element is damaged. If it's the earth element, if it is the earth element, the water element is damaged. Water is only good with air and water. Okay, water is not good with fire and earth. See, a simple formula. Air, water, fire, earth. Earth is carbon. Fire is nitrogen. Water is oxygen. Air is hydrogen. Okay. This is how these four elements are first four elements in your DNA. Okay, earth is carbon. We are made from carbon, skin. Fire is nitrogen. Water is oxygen. And air is hydrogen. So see, water is good with air. Okay, it is good with air. But water is not good with fire. Water is not good with carbon. Okay, earth element sucks the water. Fire element burns the water. Okay, see oxygen. Oxygen is not good with nitrogen. Oxygen is not good with carbon. Okay, you give out carbon dioxide. Nitrogen oxide is not good. Okay, but nitrogen and carbon are good with each other. Getting my point? Hydrogen and oxygen are good with each other. Okay, so if see over here from the fourth house of the moon, there is 1, 2, 3, 4. See, this is the one, first house, second house, third house, and fourth house. You have to see the fourth house from the moon. If any planet is there, you have to see whether the planet is air planet, water planet, fire planet, or earth planet. If planet is not there, you have to see which zodiac is over there. Then you have to see the lord of the zodiac. You have to see whether that lord is air, water, fire, and earth. Okay. If the lord is either water or air, then the person is having good water element in his body. The water balance of the body is good. But if that lord is either fire or earth, the person is not having good water element in the body. Okay, and until we know the water element, we cannot prescribe him any medicine, any Ayurvedic treatment. It is very important to see, because water is something prime necessary to understand the Pitta. Okay, Agni and Pitta. The person is having Pitta. Okay, the tendency of getting high pH, high acidic stomach. Okay, if the water element is damaged, the person can have teeth issues. And if you advise him some warm herbs like Ashwagandha, Shilajit, okay, then the person is going to be in trouble. Say for example, a person has a weak Mars. So you thought that, okay, let me prescribe him anything that boosts testosterone, anything that boosts the metabolism. Okay, so you prescribe him all this kind of warm herbs. But what happens? If the water element is not good, okay, there would be Agni. There is no water inside to calm that heat. So what happens? Side effect will come. So it would be a mistake to prescribe wrong things until and unless you understand the panchang of the person, five limbs of the person. Okay, see, there is a difference understanding the panchang of time and understanding the panchang of human body. There are many astrologers, classical astrologers, who can teach you the panchang of time, and I can say they are better than me. Okay, I have no problem in accepting that people are good, better than me in many of the cases. But there are still few cases where I am better. Okay. So yes, I do accept that sometimes when we are talking about panchang of time, there are many people who are better than me. But when we are talking about panchang of body, when we are talking about medical astrology, when we are talking about medical ancient medical science, okay, the healing arts, okay. So this is where my expertise come on. Okay. So panchang of time is different. We are coming to panchang of time after this. This is the panchang of body. That is why these planets are not astrological connection of planets. What are these planets? These planets are the connection of medical astrology. Okay, they are not the planetary lords of the tithis. Okay, don't consider like this. This is not the planetary lords of the tithis. These are the chakra lords. Okay, give a right heading over here. Chakra lords of tithi. These are not planetary lords, dude. Planetary lords are going yet to come. After this, I am going to teach planetary lords. These are chakra lords. When moon is going, what is happening inside the body? What is happening in the soul? What is happening in the body? What is happening in the system? What is happening in the vibe? That is over here. When we are talking about planetary lords with the moon cycle, the tithis, at that time, we are understanding how soul is reacting, how the jyoti inside our body, atma, atman, that is reacting. Over here, we are understanding how the body, the internal systems and the vibe field is reacting with the moon cycle. Got my point? So we were over here, then we understood the aspect. Okay, we also understood how to see the aspect. Okay, for example, from moon, okay, this is the first house, second house, third house and fourth house. At the fourth house from the moon, there is, say, Jupiter. Okay, say Jupiter is over here. Jupiter is stationed over here. Okay, Jupiter is sitting over here. Then what you have to see? You have to see the aspect of Jupiter. Where is Jupiter looking? So where does Jupiter look? Jupiter looks at the ninth house from itself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. See, Jupiter is looking over here. So, whenever the moon phase is going to change, the person's diet is going to change. Okay, and with respect to diet, with respect to Jupiter, the person's mood is going to change and speech is going to change. Because where is Jupiter aspecting? Jupiter is aspecting the third house of speech. Okay, so the change of food will change the speech of the person. Okay. So we understood this, and what else you were understanding in the last video, I don't understand because I don't remember, because I have to write this again and I have to explain you this from where I was stopped. Okay, so this is this chakra lords of tithis. Getting my point? Now coming to the planetary lords. Now the traditional panchang of time. See, traditional panchang of time is different than this panchang. See, in this panchang, these lords, these planets are not the lord of the tithis. They are lord of the chakras of the body. And these tithis are connected with the body chakras. This is how this system is derived. Getting my point? Now, we are deriving, or we are just learning the different system, the casual traditional system. The lords of the planets and the lords of the tithi. These were the lords of the chakra, body chakras, body centers. Okay. So now let's understand the lords of the planets. We start writing planets in order. Sun, Moon, Mars, Sun, Moon, Mars, after Mars comes Mercury, yes, Mercury, Venus, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, Saturn, Rahu and Ketu. We are not taking Ketu over here. Because, see, in days, when we are talking about days, when we are talking about the fire element of the body, we just considered seven planets. Okay. But now when we are talking about the water element of the body, we are considering seven planets and one node, that is Rahu. We are not considering Ketu because Ketu is eating the moon, okay? Because Ketu is the lower part of the body which is utilizing the water element. It does not have anything to do with the storage and performance and formation of the water element. In case of fire elements, only the seven planets help in generation of the fire. Okay, when we are talking about the generation of water element, eight things take a role. This Ketu is conjunction of water element. Okay, see in case of fire element, okay, seven planets were creating and Rahu and Ketu were consumption. They were utilizing. In case of water element, these seven planets and Rahu is forming, okay, and creating. And who is utilizing? This Ketu is utilizing. Okay, so we will not take Ketu in over here while we are doing count. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. So see, when we are talking about planetary lords of Tithis, what? Above, the last table was the chakra lords. Okay, these are planetary lords. These are planetary lords. See over here. If you clearly see, first what else we have to see over here is, you have to see two different things. First of all, fire element, water element, earth element, air element. Okay, which planets are fire element? Sun and Mars. Which are water? Moon and Venus. Which are earth? Mercury. Which is air? Saturn. Okay, sky element is Jupiter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 planets. Getting my point? So now see, which tithi are good actually? Which tithis are good? Which are water and air? They are good. Water and air are good. Okay. See which is water and air. Moon, Venus, and Saturn. Moon, Venus. Saturn, this is good, this is good, this is good. Okay, three are good. What about fire? Fire is not good for water. Okay, so this is not good. This is not good. Earth is not good. Absorbs the water. There is a reduction of water element. Not good. Okay. Now remains sky element, that is Jupiter. This Jupiter is very good. That is why the best tithis are Pancham and Trayodashi. Many people think that Shivratri is to be celebrated in the month of Maha. In the Maha month there is Shivratri. No. Understand the scriptures. Shivratri is the 13th phase of moon. Every month there is Shivratri. Every month. And the Shivratri taking place in Maha month is called Maha Shivratri. Shivratri taking place in Aso month is called Aso Shivratri. Getting it? Shivratri, that is 13th phase of moon taking place in Chaitra month is called Chaitra Shivratri. Every 13th phase of the moon is Shivratri, of which the 13th phase of moon which falls in the Maha month is called Mahashivratri. Otherwise, every 13th phase is Shivratri. So, this 13th phase is very good. Direct sky element is taking the water element. Water element is directly going into your prana. What can be better? Okay. So see, this 13, Trayodashi is good and Pancham is good. Very good. Intensely good. For what? For water element. Okay. Because if you want to increase or cure some diseases related to water element, you should tell the person that fast on 13th and the 5th phase of the moon. Okay. If the fire element is damaged, then you have to see the war and take remedies from war. But if water element is to be cured, is to be increased, at that time, tell the person to fast on Pancham and Trayodashi, 5th and 13th phase of the moon. Okay. If you see there is a lack of water element, the water is getting burnt because of intense fire element. The fire is high and water element is low. What you have to say? You have to say that do fast on 1st, 9th, 3rd or 11th phase. If sun is the reason, if sun is the reason of burning water element, if sun is malefic in a chart and it is burning the water element, then you have to say do fast on 1st and 9th phase, Pratipada and Navami. If Mars is bad, tell them to do fast on 3rd and 11th phase, Tritiya and Ekadashi. Many people fast on Agyaras. Why do they fast on Agyaras? They fast because they want this anger to subside. Mars is anger, Mars is rage. So your water element will subside your rage, subside your anger. What else it will subside? It will subside your sexual desires, lust. Okay, fasting on Tritiya and Agyaras will subside your lust. Okay. Now, if you see water element is already good in a person's body, but the earth element is creating problem. Okay. Then you have to say fast on 4th and 12th phase of the moon. Water is getting absorbed. Okay, water is getting absorbed. So he has to fast on 4th and the 12th phase. Now if you see, the person has no problem in earth element, no problem in fire element. Sun is good, Mars is good, Mercury is good. Still, the water element is not good. Then you have to see which of this planet is not good. Either Venus is not going to be good, either Moon is not going to be good, or either Saturn is not going to be good. If any of these three are not good, okay, you can prescribe the day, on which tithi the person should fast. Okay. And if you don't know the chart, if you don't know the chart of the person, and you just see the person and you understand, okay, water is less in this person's body, this water element is not good, and you don't know astrology, you don't know anything astrology, you don't know Vedic science, you don't know Vedic scriptures, you don't know any kind of this shastras, okay, then what you have to do? When you see your water element is going down, there is dehydration, there is pit, water is not sufficient, your skin is getting pale, you are having hair fall, and you don't know what to do, you don't have money to go to an astrologer, go to a doctor, or you just want to give advice to someone in regards to increasing their water element, to make the water element proper, exact, balance the water element in the body, then you have to tell them to fast on Ashtami. See, this Ashtami is the only moon phase that is given to Rahu. It is going to give you psychoneuroimmunity for water element. Okay, that is why Krishna, the lord of moon, you know Dashavatar, in Dashavatar, Krishna represents moon. Okay. Why? See, this is the only moon phase given to Rahu. Krishna is controlling Rahu. Krishna is controlling psycho neuro immunity of water element. He is moon in the first house. He was born on Ashtami. That is why he controlled Rahu of people. He changed the thoughts of people. He changed the perception of people. He was able to do it. He could easily convince anyone. Why? Ashtami born. Rahu strong. Okay. So, Tithi, water element. Another table. Very important table of planetary lords. How to see? You have to see from the elements. Fire element, water element, earth element, air element, sky element. And you have to give the remedies likewise. Okay. Basically, this Ashtami is always neutral. If you think your moon is bad, if you think your water element is bad, if you think your water balance is bad, you can always pass on Ashtami without watching any type of astrology. Okay. My guarantee. Within 3 months. Within 3 months, your water element is going to be good. Okay. Balanced. Right. So, this was about planetary lords. Okay. Now, there is one more thing, is that Tithi Lord. Now, what is Tithi Lord? Okay, see, these are the lords of Tithi. Now, how to see this Tithi Lord? Okay, I will give you my chart. Okay, but in my chart, it is placed in the same house. Let me again give you a random example, okay? Let's take house number 1 is Virgo, 6. Okay, for example, moon is placed over here. Moon is placed, let's say moon is placed over here. Mars is over here. Sun, Jupiter, Mercury, Saturn, and what is left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which planet is left? Sir, Moon, Mercury, Venus, Venus is left. Venus, Venus, Venus. Let's give him Sanjeev Neelo. Venus is over here. Okay. And this is Rahu. This is Ketu. Oops, I took away Sanjeev Neelo. So, just an example chart. Okay. So we have to consider, first we have to see moon, and let's take an example. This person is born on, for example, fourth phase. This person is born on the fourth phase. Okay. So now we have to see who is the lord of fourth phase over here. Who is the planetary lord of the fourth tithi? The planetary lords of the fourth tithi is Mercury. Okay. So, we have to write Mercury over here, inside, okay, keep this in the back of the mind, and you have to do a plus sign, okay, then you have to count 7 from the moon, okay, count 7 from the moon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, 7th is this house, this is the 7th house from the moon, okay, the 7th lord from the moon. See, in the day cycle, in fire, in war, we were counting from sun over here. This is the moon cycle. So, we are counting from moon. The counting starts from moon. Okay. So, the 7th count comes over here. Which is this house? 6, 5, 4. This is the 4th house. Okay, very good. The 7th lord over here is moon. Okay, see, moon is itself the 7th lord. So, we have to write over here moon. Slash, what is the planet present over here? Mars. Now consider this conjunction. This is the conjunction for water element of the body. Water element of this body, this person's body. See the sun, see the moon, count 7 from the moon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. If in the 7th house there is some planet, first you will take that into consideration. Okay. First, first you will take that in consideration. Okay, so first you will take Mercury plus Mars. That is the first thing to be taken into consideration. And then you will take Mercury plus Moon. If this combination is good, the water element of the person is good. See over here. Moon plus Mars is good. Okay, it is giving Adishesh Yog. Okay, Chandra Mangal Yog. Chandra Mangal Yog is good. But it is good for destiny. Is it good for the body? No. For the body it is not good. Because Mars represents fire. Moon is water. What happens with when fire and water mix? See, the difference between Sun and Mars is Sun is complete combustion. Mars is incomplete combustion. Okay, this is blue fire, this is yellow fire. But both are actually fire. Both are fire. So what happens when this moon, this water and fire are together? There is vapor, there is smoke. Okay, there is gas. This water is being depleted. No matter for the destiny, Moon and Mars yoke is good, but it is good not in aspect, only when they are sitting together. Okay, it is the yoga of Adishesh, Sheshna. Okay, but see over here it is the aspect, because we are seeing just the water element of the body. What is the reaction of the water element? So first you have to see the moon with the planet present over there. So the first thing you have to see is how is Mercury plus Mars, is it good? No. So the water element of the body is suffering. Okay, then you have to see the seventh lord, moon and moon. Okay, is moon and moon good? Yes, moon and moon is very good. See, moon and moon is very good. So in one aspect this is bad, in other aspect it is good. This is the cancellation of bad thing. The person is going to suffer because of the water element, but if the person drinks ample of water, this water is going to shut down the fire, excess fire. So drinking more water is the remedy of this person. Okay, let's take another example which is not this complex. Okay, let's take another example. In another example, let's see. Moon is sitting. Now Mars is sitting over here. Moon is sitting over here. Okay. So now count 7 from the moon. Okay, you have to count 7 from the moon. And let's say if we don't write this Mercury over here, because let's say now we change the tithi. The tithi is 5. Okay, this is the tithi of the person. Person is born on Pancham. Okay. So who is the lord of the tithi? Jupiter. So first you have to write Jupiter. Then we have to put a plus sign. And after plus sign, we have to calculate 7 houses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is the 7th house over here? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. See, the 7th house is Aquarius. Okay, from Moon, the 7th house is Aquarius. Okay, who is the lord of Aquarius? It is Saturn. Is this combination good? What is the combination of Jupiter and Saturn good? Yes, it is very good. Combination of sky element and air element is good. Why shouldn't it be good? Jupiter can handle Saturn. Saturn can understand Jupiter. So Jupiter-Saturn conjunction is very good. Okay. So this person is having very good water element. Okay. There is no problem with the water element of this person's body. There is no planet over here which is disrupting the water element. Okay. Plus the person is born on the fifth phase of the moon. That is very good for the water element. Thirdly, when you see the lord of the seventh house and how is the lord of the tithi with the lord of the seventh house from the moon, that is Jupiter plus Saturn, is it good? Yes, it is good. So the person is having very good water element in the body. Very good water element. Totally flexible. The person is going to be very much flexible. The muscles are going to be very much flexible. Totally flexible body. It is possible this person can also be a runner, athlete, okay, gymnast. Getting my point? So you have to see the 7th house from the moon. If the 7th house is having any planet, you have to add that planet with the tithi lord. Okay. Now let's take my example. A bit different. We'll come to a different reason, that is why. Who is the lord of my moon? The lord of my moon is Parshuram, that is Mars. Okay, so the lord of my moon is Mars. So first of all, I will write Mars and I will do the first plus sign because I am born in Tritiya. Okay, then I will count 7 houses from the moon. Okay, this is the where is moon? My moon is over here. So I have to count 7 houses from the moon. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. Okay, this is the 7th house. 7th house from moon. Okay, and what is the sign over here? What is the sign over here? 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 1. Who is the lord of Aries? Lord of Aries is Mars. See, a different result. Mars and Mars. When the lord of the Tithi is same as the 7th lord from the moon, okay, then you have to forget about elements. Forget this. Forget it. See, moon is over here. We are counting 7 houses from the moon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The 7th house is Aries. Who is the lord of Aries? Is Mars. And who is the lord of the Tithi in which I am born? It is Tritiya. It is also Mars. So when the lord of the Tithi in which a person is born, it is equal to the lord of the 7th house from the moon, you don't have to give any remedies. You don't have to give any remedies of the water element. Getting my point? The only remedy the person is going to need is of fire element of that planet, that is Mars. For that you again have to see the last session, see the session of days. From the days you will get the remedies of the days. Because what is happening over here, logically what is happening, the Tithi lord is same as the 7th lord, which means water is getting utilized by its own king. The reason of prana, the holding of prana, that is water. Who is forming the water is consuming the water. Okay, it's like there is a glass. The glass is holding the water. Okay, and you are throwing water up and again you are putting water in the same glass. The water which is getting reduced is again filled in the cup from which it is being formed. Okay, it is like the motor. Okay, you have one tank, you have another tank. From this tank, water is going over here from motor. Okay, and here you have kept a pipe. From this tank, the water is again going into this tank. So it means the water is recycling. So you have the system to recycle the water. Then why do you need to worry about water element? Forget about water element. Your body is always going to make your water element good. You have very good cleaning system of your body. Your water element is very good. But the problem here arises that if this planet is a fire element, okay, see, it is a fire element, yes. If that planet is fire element, the person will have the tendency to drink less water. If this planet is earth element, the person will have tendency to drink more than necessary water. The person can drink 4 glasses of water at once. because absorption rate is very high. And if this planet is moon, okay, forget about TTM water, the person is going to have very good water element. Okay, water is cleaning all the germs, bacteria, everything. Nishchit rahoa, water element aapka perfect hai. Agar you are born on 2nd and 10th and the 7th house of the moon is Cancer. Or moon is sitting over there. Moon can't sit over there. Okay, we will calculate from the moon. Sorry. So, if it is Cancer, 7th house of the moon is Cancer, and if you are born on either Dvitiya or 10th things, Dasami. Okay. If you are born on 6th or 14th, and this phase also, water utility is very good. Over here, water intake is very good. Over here, water utility is very good. Okay, if it is Jupiter, it is the blessing of Lord Shiva on you. Lord Shiva is blessing you. You might have done very good things in your past birth. That is why Lord Shiva is blessing you with the water element. That, oh, take water element. Water element is Mrityunjay for you. Okay, so if the 7th house of the moon is either Sagittarius or Pisces and you are born on 5th or 13th phase of the moon, remember, Shiva has given you a blessing. Mrityunjay blessing. As for how long time you will maintain the water balance of the body, you won't die. Okay, see, this is very important. I can give it in detail. If you are born on 5th phase / 13th phase, okay, and the 7th house from moon contains Jupiter or is Sagittarius or Pisces, any of these three conditions, then Shiva has given you the blessing of Mrityunjay with water element. Keep drinking water, you will not die. You can live around 96 years if you drink water consistently, clean water, pure water. If you are maintaining your water balance and if you have this yoga in your chart, I will guarantee you, you will live 96 years. Okay, but yes, you have to ensure that water element is proper. You don't have to burn your water element. You don't have to drink alcohol. You don't have to smoke. You don't have to take hookahs. You don't have to take whiskey. Vodka is okay, not whiskey, because it is heat. You have to avoid all types of heat. After the age of 78, remove all the spices from your diet. Sorry, not 78. 60. 12 is 60. After the age of 60, remove all the hot spices from your life. After the age of 84, don't eat chilies. Remove chilies. And again, you will sustain 12 years. This is my guarantee. Just have to take care of the water element. And as you get older and older, give up Sun, then give up Mars. What is Mars? Mars is all the hot spices. What is Sun? Sun is all kinds of hot waters, hot drinks. Okay, then after giving up Sun and Mars, give Jupiter. You don't have to eat all the food that causes heat in the body. Okay. So, after that, you have to leave Mercury. Drop. Don't eat salt. Start eating pink salt or rock salt, Sindalu or Sanchar. Okay, after the age of 72 years. Okay, and then at last you have to give up Saturn. That is, you have to do pranayam daily. Daily pranayam you have to do, and you have to wake up at sunrise, not before sunrise, not after sunrise. Okay, then again you will live 12 years. Okay, till the age of 84. After 84, you continue the pranayam, delete all these things from life and maintain the water balance. I am sure you are going to live 96 years. Okay. So, this was Tithis. Okay, this is Tithis. water element of the body. How to understand the water element of the body and the blood relaunch? Those who haven't written this can take a screenshot and take notes. Whoever wants to take notes can take notes. Whoever is here to take entertainment can enjoy. Enjoy. Okay. So I guess over here we should complete, what do you say, the PT section over here, because if you want to understand the elapsed PT and everything, it is an advanced concept. You have to visit Vedic Vidyala. It is where I am going to teach you. Okay. So I guess this is where I should end tithis, okay? Because we have talked a lot about tithis now. And I think we should get going. I am taking too much of details. But if you are personally joining Vedic Vidyala, if you want to personally join my classes, okay, if you want to learn astrology and what you say, chakra opening, energy science in detail, okay, then you can visit vedicvidyala.com. The link is given below, and it is where I am going to teach you more than advanced over here. This is still not advanced. People would be thinking, okay, I am teaching advanced thing over here. No, this is still the basic. When I start teaching advanced, it is like I will spend around 5 days just teaching you about fire element. Then I will spend 5 days just teaching you about water element. Okay, that is what advanced is. This is still not advanced. Okay, so it was nice understanding and knowing the two elements, that is sun and moon, fire element and water element. So we completed two things. We completed water, so we completed fire. We completed water. Okay, two things we completed in the Manchan section. Now, in the next session, I have a choice. I either have to start Karan, okay, which is the earth element, or I would start Nakshatra, which is the air element. Okay, but there is still kashmakash in my brain that what I should start first. And let's see, because see, if I start Nakshatra, I have to start everything and teach you about how Nakshatras are formed and what are the 27 Nakshatras and everything else. And if I teach you Karan first, the earth element first, then it is going to be quite easy because it is derived from Dithi. But in order to understand Karan, I have to understand you notes, and in order to understand notes, these notes are also affected by nakshatras. Okay, so I am just confused what to start first. But let's see, tomorrow is a break day because I am going out somewhere, I don't have time. But it was nice understanding fire element and water element. Tomorrow is break, day after tomorrow we will meet, either we will start with Karan or Nakshatra. And if we don't start with any of this, I am going to continue the older series, that is Ascendants, and complete the Ascendant series first. But everything depends on what happens day after tomorrow. Okay. So thank you very much to join me with Water Element. We completed the Tithi over here. Thank you everyone.